Thank you. So in the last time, I gave a definition of Thomas invariants, which may also count stoic distributive sheaves. And the definition is somewhat complicated. We have to take logarithm of the modular stack of semi-stable sheaves and take virtual Poincaré polynomial and taking some limit. And also the resulting invariant may not be necessarily integer, so it is just rational number. But anyway, so let me, as in the last lecture, let me first begin with the product formula of stable pair invariants, that is, so for X is smooth projective, by 3, then a consequence of the wall crossing formula was that if we consider the generating series of stable pairs, then it is composed into infinite product and generating sheaves of some invariant which count certain exotic object in the derived category. This was proven by using wall crossing formula in derived category. So this is the invariant which count certain one-dimensional semi-stable sheaves, which may also contribute, which may also have a contribution from stoic semi-stable sheaves. So yes, the each coefficient of this generating sheet, each coefficient is counting stable pairs, and it is each coefficient here is integer, and this is also integer, but this is not necessarily integer, so it is some rational number. And geometrically, as I explained yesterday, so a stable pair is something like pair of curves and points on curvature C-fold. On the other hand, this large N invariant is something like so this is something like counting curves and certain semi-stable bundles on it. So where there might be some higher rank vector bundle may appear in the modular space which define this large N invariant. So in some sense, so this large N invariant may look to be difficult to understand because well, first of all, well, maybe vector bundle might be more difficult than thinking about curves, thinking about points. Also, this invariant is not necessarily integer, but it is just a rational number, and it is, in general, it might be difficult to compute, like denominators of this rational number. But on the other hand, there might be some better point in this invariant. For example, let's consider the curve, C inside this threefold, and suppose that this curve is like non-singular curve of genus G. And maybe some particular, typical object which contributes to this invariant might be something like line bundles on this curve. But if you consider modular space of line bundles on a fixed smooth curve, so this is nothing but the usual Jacobian. And as I told, so this is something like the modular space of one-dimensional semi-stable sheaves. And if you consider the contribution from such line bundles on smooth curve, then it does not contribute to this invariant if the genus is positive. This is because we have Euler number of the Jacobian. So this is G-dimensional Abelian variety. So this Euler number equals zero if G is positive. So in this sense, we can rigorously state that this, the shifts which contribute to this Lagrangian invariant only supported on some genus zero curves, which may have some singular support. So I mean, for example, if you consider, maybe if you consider moduli space of shifts which define this invariant, maybe generically it looks something like this. So this might be something curved and like a line bundle. But yeah, if you degenerate it to some like singular rational curve like this, then only shifts which is supported on some such genus zero curves contribute to this invariant. So in this sense, this invariant is something like the invariant which has to do with genus zero. But of course, in the stable pair side, we have many higher genus curves, and such higher genus curves appear in this somewhat more difficult invariant. And also, another annoying thing of this invariant is that this is not integer, so this may be some rational number. But there is a conjecture which expresses this invariant as some integers. So this is called multiple cover conjecture. Cover conjecture that is invariant is written as the weighted sum of like this. So this is something like constraint among these invariants. So here, so small n refers to the Euler characteristic of the one-dimensional sieve, and this means that in thinking about this set of invariants, it is enough to know of the invariant when the homomorphic Euler characteristic equals to 1. The good point of reducing it to the homomorphic characteristic 1 is that, of course, this 1 and curve class is coprime. And in this case, there is no strictly semi-stable shifts which contribute to this invariant. So in particular, so this is the usual Donaldson-Thomas invariant, and this is. And so there is a strong reason to believe this conjecture. And indeed, it is compatible with the MNOP conjecture, which I talked in Tuesday. So if you assume the correspondence between Kolmogorov invariants and also assuming some geometric property of Kolmogorov invariants, then this equality should hold. But unfortunately, there are not so many cases where this conjecture is known. I will later explain about some examples, but let me first describe some consequences about this conjecture. Yes, indeed, if this conjecture is true, then this generating sheets of stable pair invariants and together with this product formula gives some strong property of the generating sheets of stable pair invariants. That is called Kopackmann buffer form. So, yes, in any case, we assume this multiple cover conjecture. Then it is some easy exercise about the generating series. So indeed, if you fix this curve class beta, the generating series of Lagrangian invariant was a Lorentz polynomial. And also, if you assume this multiple cover conjecture, then you can write this. So this is the term which is responsible for the rationality of the generating sheet of stable pair invariants, and this is written as some special form. Like that, there is some set of integer valued invariant for any negative integers, G and curve class beta, such that generating series of state pair invariant is given by the again infinite product like this. Minus two. Energy beta, I should write it as P because it is defined from stable pairs. And also these. Well, anyway, so this is a formal consequence about the generating sheets. And, well, and in particular, these NG beta, so these integers are explicitly are described in terms of this large N invariant and that large M invariant. So, indeed, under that conjecture, we see that N0P is indeed coincide with the invariant which appears in the right-hand side of that multiple cover conjecture. And for higher genus, it is more complicated to describe, but still it is possible to describe it. It's certain explicit polynomials of large L. So this explicit form is not important here, so I don't write it here, but anyway, so you can write it down. Beta prime, so on. Alpha is integer. Alpha is integer.
Yes.
Yes, because there is no strictly semi-stable sheaves. So this is coprime. And if this is coprime, well, there is no strictly semi-stable sheaf with this chunk character. So, okay. And yes. And yeah, anyway, so in the genus zero part, well, this is the usual Donaldson Thomas invariant. So this is just given by the integration of the parent function, where M is the moduli space of one dimensional sheaves with chain character, exactly this one, so M was. And yes, I will later, but so this has, yeah. Yeah, this kind of invariant is sometimes called Kobachmann buffer invariant. But this was not the Kobachmann buffer invariant which was originally proposed by Kobachmann and buffer. So I mean, if you know this formula and if you also know about Gromov-Witten stable pair correspondence, then you can write down the generating series of Gromov-Witten invariants in terms of this integer valued invariants. And So anyway, so this gives some hidden property, hidden integrality property of the generating series of Gromov invariants, and that was good. But original proposal of Kopakman and Buffer was, so there is some there should exist some intrinsic definition of NG beta using this moduli space. So, for example, in the genus zero case, you can write down N0 beta in terms of the integration of the virtual integration of the virtual fundamental cycle or integration of the parent function. So, in the similar way, it is expected that even so, in the higher genus case, this has some interpretation in terms of this moduli space. And maybe another comment is that we talked about the formula that exponential n terms and m terms. So this has to do with that Kopakman buffer expansion. That is, this term has to do with the genus equal zero term, and this term has to do with the higher genus term. But as I told, so the geometric object which contributes to this large area invariant is somewhat complicated object in the derived category, and it's not a priori clear what is the relationship of this term and this moduli space. Anyway, so let me give some examples. This example, which I talked last time, but when X equals to the total space of minus one and minus one, and it has projection to one, and as before, S be a zero section, and let C be the image of the zero section. Well, in this case, it is possible to explicitly compute this large N and large L invariant. So, yes, if I just write the result, S and N equals to zero if M divides N, and if coincides with one over M square, if M does not divide N. Also, largely N invariant is more easy, because as I told, so this has to do with higher genus term, but in this case, there is no higher, you don't see any higher genus curve here. So indeed, this is one if N equals M equals zero, and this is zero if otherwise. So in this way, you can compute the generating series of stable pair invariants in this local minus one curve case using wall crossing formula. Indeed, it is not enough just to substitute this. Also, this formula itself implies the multiple cover conjecture. So we're just substituting these computations, we can write case as the infinite product and this is just if you write it as the Kopakman buffer form in this way, this is given by one over k minus q k on. So anyway, so this implies that we are comparing these expressions, one can write equals to just one if g equals 0 and m equals 1, 0 otherwise. And yes, in this case, well, if you consider this moduli space of one-dimensional stable sheaves, then well, this is non-empty if and only if beta is just the reduced curve class, that is beta is the class of C. And yes, in this case, this moduli space is just 1 point. So just by taking Euler number, we get this number one. You mean this formula? What I mean is that when n equals ml for some a. This is because well, every sheaves which contribute to this variant is something like OCA. This one? So this one is empty if m is bigger than 2, bigger than or equal to 2. The far formula that is a divided by n. Yeah. Yes? Sure, you're right. Sorry, yes, exactly. Thank you very much. Yeah, exactly. And also in this local minus and curve case, so the derived category of coherent sleeves on X is derived equivalent to some representation of Kleber with some deviation coming from superpotential. And in this case, there is another interesting story of the wall crossing formula that is, we can also count 13 framed representations of that Kleber with deviation, and we can define invariants which count that framed representations. And using wall crossing formula, we can describe the generating sheets of such non-commutative Donaldson-Thomas invariant, which was worked out by Nagao and Nakajima. So, but today, I will focus on geometric situation and don't talk about such a non-commutative situation. And so another example which I talk is, so here in this example, we can observe higher genus curves. So this is example is one of Strauss model. So the setting is that let S be smooth, objective, let surface. And let's take two general element of the global sections of S or S minus 4KS and G global section of S minus 6KS. And then we can construct certain Calabi-Yau threefold form defined by these global sections, that is by X is plus OS given by equation like y square equals x square plus fx plus g. Here the x is a coordinate of here, and y is a coordinate of here. So in this way, so this is Calabrese fold. Projective Calabrese fold, and this is elliptic fibration. So that every fiber is an integral plane curve in P2. So in this case, it is also possible to compute this large N and large F invariant, which when the curve class is contained in the fibers of this of the projection to S. So you have just write the result. Not difficult to compute it, but first, okay, so let F be fiber class, fiber of pi. Then this large N invariant is given by like minus summation of A by the nm, and Euler number of x. And in particular, so this large N invariant satisfies the multiple cover conjecture. And we can also compute this large N invariant. In this case, this is also easy to prove because, for example, if you consider the case that where this small n is non-zero, then the moduli space which defines this invariant is indeed empty. So the invariant is zero if zero, and when n equals zero, then this is then this, the moduli space which is each computes this invariant is nothing but the Hilbert scheme of points on the base S. So in particular, so this is the Euler number of the Hilbert scheme of points when n equals zero. Yes, A divides. A divides both N and M. Anyway, by just substituting this, we get the formula like just take sync the contribution from curves that is supported on fibers. Then this is written in terms of infinite product. M. and minus dm minus s. And in particular, comparing this product expansion in, with the previous Quark-Gamma buffer form, we see that we have N0 MF P coincides with just minus of Euler number of X and N1 just coincides with ES, and there is no contribution from a higher genus. So anyway, in these cases, for example, it is directly possible to compute the stable pair invariant using wall crossing formulas. But anyway, what is missing in this story is about how to give more geometric and intrinsic understanding of the higher genus invariant. So as I described here, in the genus zero case, the story is perfect. This is nothing but the weighted Euler number of the modular space of one-dimensional stable sheaves. But in the higher genus case, it is written as a certain combination of polynomials of large invariant, and it is quite much more mysterious thing. And so, indeed, yeah, from the original proposal by Quark-Gamma and Buffer, we can expect the following thing. So this is somehow a Bogue conjecture. So just I state it as a quotient mark. This Bogue conjecture is that where this beta p is interpreted in terms of this modular space of one-dimensional stable sheaves. So this conjecture is, I think it should be interpreted as something like stable pair and Quark-Gamma buffer correspondence. Yes, and I'm not going to explain what kind of interpretation we should do. And indeed, well, and this interpretation should be formulated as something like virtual number of dimensional abelian variety in this modular space. And one of the problems about this conjecture is that still we don't have a satisfactory theory to give the virtual count of G-dimensional abelian variety inside this modular space, except the genus equals zero case. Of course, in the genus zero case, so this means counting number of points in this modular space. And in this case, we have not a virtual fundamental cycle and we can integrate it. But in the higher genus case, we don't have such a theory. So in order to give some intuition about this statement, let me give some more easier example. So this is the rigid curve case. So let's suppose that C is a smooth genus curve. And suppose that she is rigid inside here, inside in X. That is super rigid, so there is no infinitesimal deformation of X. So in such situation, if we consider the modular space of stable pairs, curve class, just this single curve C, then as I told before, in this case, this moduli space of stable pairs is nothing but the giving stable pair is nothing but giving some line bundle on C and its global section. And such moduli space is given by just symmetric product of this curve C. This means this moduli space is given by symmetric product of n plus g minus 1c. Number is defined because of the some compatibility with the chain character. Anyway, so we have this identification of the moduli space, and in particular, because C is non-singular, so this moduli space of stable pairs in this case is also non-singular, and the associated stable variant is by just minus 1 and plus g minus 1, Euler number of this product. So anyway, we can take consider the generating series with what we get is, well, this is the generating series of the symmetric product of the curve, and it is well known that we can describe this moduli, this generating series of the Euler number of the symmetric product in the following way. So this is nothing but we have Q1 minus 2. And in particular, we have in this case, in HP, yes, sorry. And in this case, n 0 equals to 0 if H is 0 and not G, and this is 1, H equals G. And if we compare this observation with this some conjecture, so in this case, where the moduli space of one-dimensional stable sheaves with curve class C is nothing but the usual Jacobian of C. Of course, this is G-dimensional abelian variety. Maybe this may give some intuition about why this number has to do with the number of like G-dimensional abelian variety inside the moduli of one-dimensional stable sheaves. Also, yes, another mysterious phenomena about on this is that so this sheaves it's has to do with the Poincaré polynomial of this dimensional abelian variety. That is, so indeed, consider the usual Poincaré polynomial with Q replaced by minus Q, then this is nothing but 1 plus Q to G, because this is topologically the product of S1. So here it's okay. So there is a difference from of this power. Yes, so PQ is usual Poincaré polynomial. And I'm just taking the some Q to minus Q. You see that some similarity of the Poincaré polynomial of the moduli space of stable one-dimensional stable sheaves and this Kobachmann perfect expansion of the moduli space of the generating sheaves of stable pairs. And roughly speaking, well, this conjecture might be somewhat formulated as like something like the generating series of stable pairs might be written as 13 Poincaré polynomial of the moduli space of one-dimensional stable series. So this is some instance of that, some Bogue conjecture. And yeah, but here, yeah, this is quite mysterious phenomena because the role of the variable Q is quite defined from here to here. So here, so the variable Q is responsible for the number of points on this curve C. And on the other hand, the variable Q here appears as the variable of the Poincaré polynomial. So the role of the variable is quite different, but nevertheless, so there is some similarity of these two, of two polynomials. And also, as I talked before, where this generating series of stable pairs is indeed in this case polynomial, and this is this is invariant undertaking Q to 1 over Q, and that symmetry is coming from the self duality or Grothendieck duality. On the other hand, maybe after just multiplying it with Q minus G, we also have symmetric property of this polynomial after taking Q to 1 over Q. But that symmetric property is coming from the Poincaré duality or Bernier duality. So yes, indeed, yeah, both have symmetric properties, but the source of the symmetry is also different. So yeah, anyway, I'm going to give some more. Anyway, at this moment, it is possible, I think it is more or less possible to describe this conjecture a mathematically precise way, at least when M is non-singular. So that is the work by Hosono Saito Takahashi in 2001. And in order to state about this, I need to prepare some notion of purpose sheaves. First, let me briefly recall about Faber's sheaves. So this is an object in the derived category of constructive sheaves on a variety that belongs to some Hartree T-structure. So that is, let's assume that T is a variety over compact numbers, and so let's consider on T. So this is the category of constructive sheaves. So this is a certain. This is the here constructive sheaf means that I mean it is always the coefficient is always a rational number, and yes, so this is a sheaf on T, sheaf of Q vector space on T that is locally constant along certain strata of this variety T. And it's certain heart of T structure on the derived category of this category of constructive sheaves. This is the called category of perverse sheaves, and this is defined in the following way. So this hat is given by object in type category, so that for any irreducible closed sub-variety of dimension D, have that its pullback to this sub-variety is contained in some or equal to minus DZ, and I star the dual of E is also contained in here. So this is the this means the web whose cohomology is concentrated on less than or equal to minus d in the standard part of this structure. And this d is the so-called Bayesian dual. That means, for example, if t is non-singular, then this dualizing functor is just given by Hamilton to by twice of dimension of t. So anyway, so this was first introduced by in the work of Bevinson, Bevinstein, Duin. For example, natural object which lives in this, what is that? Right, for example, if we have a system, local system on this closed sub-variety on Z. I start V shifted by dimension of Z. So this is an example of the purpose part. And also in a similar way, let's, for example, suppose that T is like just a fine line. And let's consider the exact sequence of the usual constructive shapes that is like given by 0 to V to 1, 2, 0 to 0. So 0 is just origin. So this is a constructive shape on a fine line. That is zero in the origin, but and at other point, this is just one-dimensional. So we can just take the from this exact sequence, we get the sequence like this: Q zero to one to one shifted by one. So as I described here, so each Q0 and QA1 shifted by 1 are power shifts. So this is interpreted as exact sequence in the category of power shifts. And in particular, this object is an example of power shift. The power shift is required in order to apply the so-called Bevinson, Bevinstein, Duin decomposition theorem. That is. Let's consider smooth variety Y and consider a projective morphism. Then in this situation, and let's write ICY to be the, so there is a notion of intersection complex. That is when on singular, on non-singular variety, this is nothing but constant shift shifted by its dimension. So this is, of course, very example of power shift, Y. And this power shift has a strong property that if you take the push forward, of this IC shift, so this lives in the derived category of constructive shifts in this in dance there. Sorry, so this is projective morphism. So this decomposes into the direct sum of its cohomology with respect to the power T structure on here. That is. I by I. So this is P of I pi star is by the ith cohomology of the push word. So this is to the power of T structure. So this decomposition theorem is a consequence of the so-called Hard-Weishaupt theorem, that is if H is ampli divisor on Y, I mean pi ampli divisor on Y, then composing the H product H I times gives isomorphism of this power series, that is of minus I by lower star Y is equal to P of I Y. So now I'm going to apply this construction to the moduli space of one-dimensional stable sheaves. So let M be moduli space of one-dimensional stable sheaves with Chern character 0, 0, beta 1. And there is a natural map from here to the so-called Chern variety. So this is the moduli space which parameterizes one-dimensional effective cycle on X. So this is moduli effective one cycles set with homology class coincides with beta. So this is known to be a projective variety that, for example, you can look at this construction in Kohler's book of rational curves on algebraic varieties. And the map from here to here is that, well, this is just sending one-dimensional sheaf to its set of theoretic support. This means this is given by like I F I bar, so eta I is just, well, this is the set of scheme theoretic point of X whose closure has dimension 1. Then we have this map, and this is, of course, this is a projective morphism. Hi, and so this map is called Hilbert-Chern map. So just applying the decomposition theorem, which appears here, we can define the following. So this is applies only when the moduli space of stable sheaves M is non-singular. So assume M is non-singular. In this case, we define beta by the following. So take the sum of all the characteristic of I star I C Y by I. So by this decomposition theorem and also by this Hardy-Weinstein theorem, this is a certain polynomial of y that is invariant under taking y to 1 over y, and just by the formal property of such polynomial, it is uniquely written as like this, is beta y over 2 plus minus 2. Why? Oh, so yes. Yeah, so this is a little bit modification of the definition of Kobach-Mbapa invariant, which was originally proposed by Kobach and Mbapa, and later formulated by Hosono, Saito, Takahashi. So anyway, the conjecture is under the assumption that M is smooth. Then the Kobach-Mbapa invariant defined from stable pairs, it coincides with the invariant which appears here. Yes, one of the remark is that, well, this is obviously true if G equals 0. Well, this is because if, well, in the genus 0 case, N0 beta P is given by the weighted Euler number of the main function. But if in the situation that M is non singular, this is nothing but the usual Euler number. And on the other hand, from this definition, if you just substitute y equal minus 1, then you get just an Euler number for N0 beta. And the problem is higher genus case. And higher genus case, this conjecture is widely not known. And also another remark is that if, for example, if you just take the child variety, for example, in the case that curve is rigid inside X, then in this case, child variety is just 1 point. And in this case, taking a purpose pushword is nothing but taking just the cohomology, ice cohomology of M. And in that case, well, this is just the rearrangement of the Poincaré polynomial of M in terms of this formula form. And originally, so they defined Kobach-Mbapa invariant using the SL2 actions on the cohomology of M and pick out the character and trace of such SL2 action, or more precisely SL2 product, SL2 action associated to the Bernstein-Dewey decomposition theorem. But it is easy to just write the definition in terms of this way, and here, so this term appears as a certain character of SL2 representation of the cohomology of G-dimensional Abelian variety, or in other words, this is related to the Poincaré polynomial of G-dimensional Abelian variety multiplied by something QG something. Not why by Okay, so, yes. I was going to describe some example about this conjecture, but so today time is over, so I will talk it tomorrow. And tomorrow I will talk about some example about this conjecture and how you talk about work in progress with Tavish-Movic to understand this conjecture when M is not smooth. So today, yeah, that's it. Thank you very much.